This PPC multi-channel dashboard recently went viral on LinkedIn, got over 2,000 comments, and caught the attention of the Marketing O'Clock podcast.
This week's cool tool comes to us by way of Adrian Decker on LinkedIn. The dashboard is built out by Boris Vasilchuk and the Coupler IO team.
It's no surprise. Thousands of marketers love it. They benefit from getting data from multiple ad platforms into one place without the need to copy-paste data, switch tabs, or even write a code. And to help you maximize this dashboard potential, I created a video guide with setting it up and adding the conversions. So, let's dive in. Hi, my name is Boris Vasilchuk, and I'm Product Marketing Manager here at Coupler.io. And today I'm going to show you how to set up a PPC multi-channel dashboard and customize it with adding conversions. So, you receive the link to the dashboard, and on the left side, you can see the setup guide tab, where all the steps to connect your data are described. And so let's see what we have here. A first step is to install the Coupler.io connector in Looker Studio. That only needed for the first time, and for the video purposes, I already installed it, but I will show you how it looks like when you do this for the first time. So you click on Install Connector, it should be Coupler.io, and Looker Studio requires a vectorization to connect your data. So we click Authorize, choose our Google account, click again Authorize, allow Coupler.io to connect to the Looker Studio. Next, Coupler.io requires authorization, let's authorize. You will be asked to log into your Coupler.io account, but also if you don't have an account, you can create one. So you just can sign up with a Google with a single sign-on. And click authorize. Success. Okay. So after that, we already authorized our account within Looker Studio, and we can return to the setup steps. And let's click on the Setup Coupler.io Importer button. You'll be asked to log in to your account. It's also could be done easily with your Google account. And after that, you will land to the predefined setup flow for the dashboard inside the Coupler.io. And here you can connect your ad accounts in just a few clicks. So let's connect our Facebook ads accounts. And Google Ads accounts. Yep, so for the video purposes, I'll use only these two sources, the most popular. And the next step is connect Looker Studio account. So let's follow the steps. Let's click on generate data source. And everything is done automatically. You just need to click connect. After connection, you will see this window with dimensions and metrics. And on this step, let's return to the setup guide. So on this step, we connected our data source to the dashboard. And here are some steps required for proper formatting of the numbers. So let's change CPC and CPM into the currency format and US dollars and CTR into the per seat format. Yep, alright. And after that, let's click create a report. So in that way, you will receive the copy of the PPC dashboard template with connected Capillary.io importers. The last step of the setup guide is do not return to get back to Capillary and finish the importer setup. So let's get to it. And let's click on the setup schedule. And in that way, you can schedule your importer to get your data automatically populated into the dashboard. So let's save an importer. And yeah, you will land to the dashboard importer window where you can see which sources are connected, what is the schedule, details. And this will be your command center for manipulating with data before sending it to the Looker Studio. After the successful import, your data will be sent to the template copy. But as for now, there is no data because for video purposes, I use test account without data from the last 60 days. And this is the period that we set by default for this dashboard template. So, let me show how you can change the date period for your connectors. So you go under the data source settings and just change the start date and end date. To get some data, I'll use the July 2023 and the end of July. And for Google Ads, I'll make the same. So let's choose 2023, July 1st, and July 2023, 31st. Alright, finish and proceed. So that will be enough. We can just click run. So the import is successful, and let's move to the date period that we put into the data source settings. So that's 2023 July 1st and 2023 July 31st. Apply. And here is our data. So yeah, and you can customize everything, change logo, whatever you want. Now let's move to the customization part. So let's return to the Capillary.io importer and let's add under the data source settings the desired conversion. So let's start from the Facebook ads and under the metrics and dimensions, let's add conversion that we want to show in this dashboard and then compare it side by side with Google Ads, the same conversion. So let's, in my case, it's the registration completed. Yeah, we can see, yeah, here it is, conversion. Conversion is complete to registration and finish and proceed. So here we connected to the conversion, and for the Google Ads, we have to do something else. So let's click on edit, and because of the API structure of Google Ads, we have to create a copy of the data source, Google Ads data source, and choose other report where our conversions are located. So let's jump to the very basic settings. And here will be a report type. And let's find the conversion campaign's performance with conversions actions name. You'll be asked to reset transformation. Yep. And finish and proceed. And let's also rename this data connection conversions. And let's change the report period as we have made in the previous data sources. So let's choose the July 1st to July 2023. Here we are done and let's move to the transformations step, where we will make a data blending from both sources. And so on the transformation tab, you will see the process of extracting data, and by default we show the first 500 rows for you as a preview for faster data manipulations. And data extraction is done, and you will be asked to apply new shape of the data. Let's apply. On the left side you will see the connected data sources and performed data transformations, and here is the data append that we made predefined for the template purposes. And here is the tab where all the data from all connected channels is blended. On this step, let's add the newly created data connection, that's Google Ads conversions. Click append data. Now this step will contain the data from all resources that we connected. Let's start to prepare data to have conversions under the same name. So let's go to the Facebook ads, and we have added the conversions complete registration, but we don't need all of the columns. You can click on the columns button, and here are newly added conversions with different attribution windows, but we only need the completed registration total. So let's pick it, and here it is, and let's rename it to have one name both in the Facebook ads data source and in Google ads data source. So let's name it, for example, sign up. Apply. And now let's move to the Google ads conversions preparation. So here we have to go to the columns and find two columns. The first is all conversions, which will give us the actual number of all conversions. And the second is conversion action name. Yep, it's already chosen. And these columns we will need to distinguish our signup conversion from all conversions. To do this, let's make a filtration. Oh, and let's find our conversion action name field contains, and I know that this is a signup because that's how it named in the Google Ads account. Yep, and now we have only signup conversions here, and data filtered here will be then sent to the Looker Studio. And last step, let's rename all conversions column into the same as we've named in the Facebook ads data source. So it's conversions sign up, apply, and let's find the rest of the active columns that we don't need in our Looker Studio. So here they are. In conversion action name, we also can hide. And the same with these two columns. You can hide them just clicking on their name. Now we can double check on the append tab that we received one conversion signup column that is common for all data sources that we've transformed. And now, after all the preparations done, we can run the importer, and after successful data import, return to the template itself. The import is successful. Let's return to the template. Let's go to the resource, edit, refresh fields, and we should receive the new metric. Yeah, new fields sign up. That's the sign up conversions column that we created in the Caplario importer. Let's apply this new field, and here it is, sign up in the number format. Okay, we are done here. And as this metric is already imported to the Looker Studio, you can add it wherever you want. So let's, for example, add it to the sources table. So we have this table, metric list. Under the conversions, we received newly created signup metric. With drag and drop, we just put it here. And here it is. So signup column with the breakdown by the channels and with the total. So I took this data from the real accounts and let me show them. So here is the Facebook Ads account, the July data, registration completed, only one conversion, it's filtrated already. And Google Ads account, also July 2023, the total number of signups, 157, as in our dashboard. So in that way, you can add the desired metric into the PPC multi-channel dashboard. And if you have some struggles with the customization, you can also ask the Caplarayo support. They are humans and they can ask you not in a robotic way. And also there is the option to have an onboarding from our representatives that will show you more capabilities of the Caplarayo. That's it. I will leave the link to the dashboard in the video description so you can try to set up it yourself. If you have any questions or requests regarding future videos, feel free to leave them in the comments. If you enjoyed this video, give us a like, share with others, and subscribe to our channel so you never miss a thing. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video!